I would have asked for help at all, but you never even noticed there was a problem. How could you? Alcohol bursts naivety, and your eyes blur at the sight of me. Your voice is raised in rage, filled with disgust, because I was not the son you wanted. My door slammed, and you did not even have enough compassion to check on me. I bet you didn't even know I cried myself to sleep. Every night. Not even my friends knew. I was delicate and innocent to them. A girl without problems. Always a smile on my face. It was a mask, but every day they were grateful for it. And my words, when they had troubles of their own. Yet they were naive too. They didn't even question my knowledge on how to defend themselves against pisshead parents. But Serena did. She saw through everything, but didn't approach me for a whole year. I knew she was aware. I saw her staring at me with wonder in her eyes, constantly. I didn't care. After all, you both gave me so much to worry about. I guess I should tell you about her, shouldn't I? Are you bastards that much? Maybe you'll connect with her, finally realize the mistakes you made, rather than sheltering the blame on the booze in your hands. I loved her. She opened my eyes. The perfect revelation. At first it was a game. No one even cared that we patched occasionally. Several times we were cheered by peers when teachers tried to break us up. Then, every night in my room, instead of being drawn into sorrow, I closed my eyes and couldn't block her out. I was drawn to her. In what seemed like a split second, I was whispering her name to myself, adding my surname in place of hers. After all, who says fetish dreams cannot come true? But did she feel the same? I had doubts. This couldn't make any sense. I'd always liked boys, but Serena was lovely. Better than the assholes that occasionally tried to sweet-talk their way into my nippers. Then, I decided the more minutes I took to make plans, the longer I was delaying inevitable love. And it was. In the end, all of this was an accident, but I'm glad we crashed into each other's embrace. All those times you thought we were painting each other's nails like ordinary teenage girls in my room. But no. We were locked in the sanctuary of each other's arms. I lost my innocence that day when she went home. I could still taste her in my mouth and feel her soft touch between my legs. Then my friends began to change. They saw the theme of what was previously a game morphing, and they were not fond of the idea. It was new. It was change. Fear is the enemy in the mind of a homophobe. A fear that makes it too scary for someone to accept something different. And no one accepted it. Hatred plagued the playground. The classrooms and the teachers were no better. How could they be? To side with something abnormal would be to make yourself so. And they could not afford that. So we ran. We hid. Out of sight, out of mind. The shunning was too much to bear. Everyone we had loved was now a nemesis. I thought in you I could trust. But then you heard the rumors and asked maliciously if I was a dyke. Obviously I denied it. I could not face another beating. The world seemed to dawn on me. An uncomfortable burden, but this time I had someone to share it with. This was comfort. We were in the park one day when Serena declared her love to me. We were under shade, the rays of sun barely creeping through the tree leaves, casting shapes in the clouds of crying rain that made us completely down. She whispered, "If they hurt you, they hurt me too." I kissed her. I loved her, there and then. The months went on, the abuse grew more dramatic. Dyke, leser, fanny muncher, cunt kisser. And many more. Everyday offences that homophobe intellect created. And Serena, undeveloped in defence against verbal atrocities, cried. It took me a while to decide to do this. No doubt you're reading this after finding me bled to death in the bathroom. A slash to my wrist. A razor in a bloodied, pale hand. I could not put past you to care. But I do. I wrote this explaining everything, so you would finally understand me. I did this for Serena. I was hurting her life, damaging everything. I guess destruction runs in the family. but my gene changed it to outward rather than self. It was this that made me realize Serena would soon turn to you. I could not allow the only one decent person in my life to be transformed into a demon. So I decided to set her free. It took me 30 minutes to write this. The blink of the night. You have found this in the morning. You might grieve, and Serena will be destroyed. I don't expect you to care for her. She is like me, someone you neglected. But 30 minutes is not a long time. It only takes 30 minutes to alter a life. So make hers better, because I'm serious shit. I feel totally lost, and I'm out of ideas on how to make her happy. It's your job now. This is the first and only time in your life that I'll ever ask you to do this. Listen.